The 18 canola crops, probably about as big of a mixed bag as you can have. And we talked about it all year. There was some areas that looked okay, some areas that didn't look okay. And that's kind of what we're seeing on yield. There was some areas of canola that that folks are pulling out, you know, in between 10 and 15 bushels, and there's some areas that folks are pulling out in between 30 and 40 bushels. So it's a mixed bag. It's just spotty. If you caught rains in March and April, you did pretty good. If you didn't, that's where we saw a lot of our canola that was a lot shorter than normal, and a lot less seed than normal. The interesting thing is harvest was a difficult challenge. I know a lot of folks, because of these late rains, had an issue with swathing versus direct cutting. And we saw a lot more direct cut canola this year than we have in more recent years. And at least from what I hear from folks that have, they were quite successful with it. But once again, it just kind of contributes to that mixed bag of canola that we had since probably about fall, when we were getting those spotty rainfalls. And that's kind of just been the story of the season. And why don't we just carry on the whole story of variability? And that's kind of where we're seeing some of our more challenging winter crop areas, you know, especially in some of our areas in Woods counties and far western Oklahoma. They have some really good looking summer crops. They've caught these late April rains, early April rains, and some of the milo and the cotton and the soybean out in that part of the world looks a little bit better than their canola and their wheat did a couple of months ago. Realistically, we're in a tough spot in some areas. I pulled this sorghum plant here, and probably some growers, depending on where you are, probably have sorghum that looks very similar to this. In the heat of the day, you can start to see some of these grass crops start to roll up on the leaves. And it's really, whenever you see a whole field of it, it looks like we're growing pineapples in Oklahoma, because it looks just like a whole bunch of pineapple leaves. This is just the sorghum's natural defense mechanism for losing water. And so if growers go out at 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock in the morning, they should still see these leaves fully opening, trying to get a little bit of sun before the heat of the day kind of comes. With this week and this weekend's cooler temperatures and some periodic rainfall, we should start to see some of these things open up a little bit. A lot of our real early sorghum maturing hybrids are getting to be at flower, or their heads are starting to come out of the boot. Some of our really early planted soybeans are getting to reproductive stage. So if you do have water, now's the time to probably do those supplemental irrigation passes, because we are getting towards that really, really critical stage for our corn, our sorghum, and our soybean, especially those that got planted early.